Wetlands are the kidneys of the landscape, filtering and cleaning water for all our benefit. As the amount of wetlands shrinks due to human development, we are losing that vital service. Restoration of traditional wetlands can be very expensive, but Floating Wetlands offers a cost-effective and scalable solution for regaining function in the landscape. They can fit into places where traditional wetland restoration isn't an option. Dr. Peter May of Biohabitats tells us about the history of tidal marshes in the Inner Harbor.
The Inner Harbor here is ultra urban. It's very built up to the water's edge. And historically, that was not the case. There were forests and wetlands that ring the harbor before the Europeans came and essentially colonized the area. But these forests and wetlands were part of a natural filtration that nature provides to the water bodies here.
How can nature provide solutions to environmental problems?
In our field, in the environmental field, in restoration and restoration design and ecological engineering, we look to nature for solutions. So nature has been around a lot longer than humans have, and it's found solutions and it knows how to do the job. But what we need to do is use what we can learn from natural systems, from nature, and come up with those solutions. And the Floating Wetlands are one of those solutions that we came up with.
If a friend told you he was off to take a dip in Baltimore's Inner Harbor, you'd probably be concerned for his health and sanity. But in the near future, swimming in Baltimore's Inner Harbor might not sound so crazy.
The Healthy Harbor Initiative is something that's been spearheaded by the Waterfront Partnership of Baltimore and all of the partners that are involved with that, most all from the Inner Harbor here and the Baltimore area. And what it intends to do is to make the harbor swimmable and fishable by 2020. That's coming up quick. It's a very lofty goal, but in making it such a lofty goal and in such a short time frame, we're putting a lot of immediacy to it and putting a lot of effort to bear on coming up with solutions to some of the problems associated with that.
Floating wetlands are a way of achieving that goal, and they're not a new idea. They already exist in nature.
Mexico City has its floating wetlands, and in the Middle East, there are these very unique systems that naturally evolved over time. We've come up with an ecologically engineered solution that can add that component that's now missing from the harbor. These wetlands, so they're floating, how do you get a wetland to float? One thing that we see a lot of that comes down into the harbor when it rains are plastic bottles. And those come into the harbor and they're scooped up by Mr. Trash Wheel over there on the other side of the harbor. Well, we said, what can we do with these? Well, we can recycle them. Well, what we decided to do was to upcycle them. We took these bottles and we essentially fit them into a sandwich, a wetland sandwich. And those are the flotation devices that are used in these floating wetlands.
In addition to cleaning and filtering the water in the harbor, wetlands attract wildlife needed for a healthy ecosystem.
One of the important aspects of these is providing habitat for wildlife that no longer exists here in the harbor. I mean, really, the wetlands were here historically, provided a place for waterfowl, for ducks and geese, and for birds like red-winged blackbirds to utilize. These floating wetlands also, because they're floating, are out in the water, and they provide habitat also for the organisms under the water. So it's a whole ecosystem that's essentially self-organized. You create the space for them, and then they instantly move in, and they seem to love it.
If you'd love to get involved and start making a difference, the first step is to come down and take a look.
The community can get involved essentially by understanding these things, but one thing that they're meant to do is the floating wetlands are in a very, very small way. They take up some of the pollutants that run off the streetscape around the harbor here, and even for all the way up into Baltimore County. And so what people can do up in the watersheds is understand how rainwater impacts everything downstream. I would encourage anyone who's interested in this kind of work. This is an excellent example of ecological engineering. And you don't have to be an engineer to be an ecological engineer, but you do have to understand the environment, ecology, and how things work, and how to put them together to solve problems. And we feel like that's an area that is a field that's going to be growing in the future as we look to nature to solve some of our problems and some of those solutions.
Visit your local BCPL branch to learn more about our environment and how you can volunteer in your local community. Check out these titles.